I have finally installed the first fat tire I've ever had on the Brompton, and this video is going to be entirely about my experience riding and testing the new tire. If you are interested in the technical details of what kind of fat tires you can install and how to install them, where to get the tires, the exact sizing, all of the parameters, that stuff is now in my Patreon. You can click on the link below to get there. Again, this video is just going to be about my first experience riding a Brompton with a fat tire on the front wheel. This whole channel is about small wheel bikes. If you're interested in small wheel bikes and also electric bikes, you might want to subscribe. There are many channels out there about the specifically the Brompton. This is not really a Brompton channel. The Brompton is my main bike right now, so many of my videos are about it, but I also have videos about other small wheel stuff. The tire I installed is the 1.5 Scorcher from the Greenspeed Trike company. This is a tire that's supposed to fit the Brompton without too much modifications. I imagine some people may have to either remove the mod guard or make some modifications to it. I talk about that option in detail in my technical videos. My installation process was actually quite straightforward. I usually ride with an electric hub in the front, but this time around I decided to use the original front wheel that came with the Brompton. I removed the battery, I removed the electric hub from the front, so you are looking at the Brompton pretty much in its original shape, although I have a lot of upgrades otherwise. I have a fairly heavy saddle, I have a suspension seat post, but other than that, it's basically the stock Brompton that I bought 4 years ago. This is a 2017 nickel plated Brompton, and I took it at first to Harlem because of the nasty road qualities there. My main concern about this tire is that it might get punctured. It's definitely not as heavy or well protected as what you would get from a Schwalbe product, especially from the Schwalbe Marathon. This is a much, much lighter tire. It doesn't look very big compared to the standard size 1.35 tire. This is really not that much of a difference, but it kind of looks cooler. When you look at the mod guard, the tire kind of flows as one with the mod guard because there is so little space left. I think I have maybe 3 or 4 millimeters left between the tire and the mod guard. Overall, the feel is definitely more comfortable. Since I only upgraded the front tire, I did not feel any change under my butt. It was mainly the front, my forearms and my wrist, my hand, that felt more comfortable. You also feel a greater sense of road contact and security, especially around corners when you might lean in. And this was to be expected. What's surprising to me is that the minimum PSI on this tire is only 40, as opposed to a minimum of 77 to 80 on the Schwalbe Marathon at 135 size. So the tire pressure has been reduced by half, I would say, and yet the rolling resistance is actually less. I actually felt like I was accelerating a bit faster than I did last time, and it was just easier to pedal. And I really wish I had the same tire installed in the rear as well. That must be quite the experience. Obviously, many people buy these for trikes, and they inflate them to 90 and 100 psi. That would be an amazing experience. So if what you're looking for is not the comfort, but the speed and an easier acceleration, that these are superb racing tires that are very light, have a lot less rolling resistance than most anything that comes standard with the Brompton, except for the Kojak, obviously. My purpose was not so much to make the tire run faster. I already have an electric hub, So what I was looking for was mostly the comfort in having a greater sense of security. When you're riding on a 100 PSI tire, hitting a tiny twig or pebble can spell the end. And so this supersizing of the tire definitely solved that. You feel a lot more secure as far as the front tire is concerned. I took the bike into Central Park after Harlem. Central Park is much smoother. It is a lot safer ground. So I was just testing the speed and the overall feel of it. Overall, I would say there's no turning back at this point. Even if I have more flats than I had with the Schwalbe tire, I would not go back to the previous tire. And I think anyone who tries this tire is going to say the same thing. Yes, it's very expensive. It's about twice the price of what you would pay for a fairly high-quality Schwalbe Marathon, which you could have for about $40. I paid close to $80 for this tire. But still, the quality is definitely worth it. I will post videos after a long time when I'm through several months of riding with this bike to give you an idea of how durable the tire is. I'm thinking it's probably not as durable as a Schwalbe. It is simply too light and it has no treads on it. So I just don't see how it would last as long. And I'm also not sure as to when the tire is supposed to be replaced. On the marathon tires, I replace the tire when the tread looks really worn. On this tire, there is no tread, so I imagine when I start seeing the Kevlar belt coming through, that's when the replacement is going to occur, or I might just wait until I get a flat and the whole thing blows up. So I don't know how long it's going to last, but the installation was surprisingly easy, and this tire is definitely recommended for anybody who wants either more comfort, or more speed, or a lighter bicycle overall. Again, I will be back a few months from now. It's getting cold in New York, so I don't know how much I can ride. But once I put some mileage into this tire, I will have a much better idea about the longevity of it. And I will definitely post videos on that. Again, if you're interested in small wheel bikes, you may want to subscribe.